Let's move to the lowest or the least integer function. Now, for least integer function, what the lowest number that is either greater or equal to the given value that we are talking about, let's say x. So using the short number line here to assume we have a here, we have b here, and the number equation or the function equation is, let's say, x. Here we want the number that is least but greater or equal to. We know that a is lesser than x, b is greater than what? X. But we want the least number that is greater than x. Here we know that we can get other numbers that are also greater than x. Let's say we have c here, we have d here, but all these numbers are greater than x. But which one is the smallest among them? No doubt it is b. So we said least integer function is the number that is least but greater than the number in question, and this one. So let's try to end our number line here. So any number that falls between a and b for least integer function, we refer it to what? B. As simple as that. So let's take some example and we denote it by x in the square bracket. X in the square bracket will be equal to what? B when we represent it on a number line. Okay, let's take these same values and find out their least integer functions. The least integer function for 4.8, what will it be? Let's try placing it on the number line. We know 4.8 is in between 4 and 5. What numbers that are greater than 4.8? 5 and above, but which one is the least one among them? It is 5. So we refer 4.8 back to what? 5. So our least integer function for 4.8 is actually 5. Okay, also taking the least integer function for minus or negative 0.5, which is a negative half, what will be our value? We can place it on the short number line. We have our negative 0.5 here. It's in between negative 1 and 0. Which of them are greatest but least one? This is the greater one in the least one, so we refer it back to what? 0. So the least integer function for negative 0.5 is actually 0, and that's what that. Now let's try to find the graph, how the graph looks like for least integer function. It's just the opposite of this one. Assuming we have a number line, y axis, x axis, we have our 0, minus 1, 1, 2, 3. We know when we stand at 0, 0 is a whole number. So we do not bother. 0 is still 0. But any number which falls within 0 and 1, we refer it to what? 1. And any number that falls within negative 1 and 0, we refer it to what? 0. So negative 1 itself doesn't fall part of the graph. When it's between 0 and 1, we refer all to what? 1, except 1 itself. So we have the open space here. From 2 also, we have 2. From 3 also, have an open space. And that's it. So you can see that the only difference between the graph of greatest and least integer function is their endpoint. We can find out that for greatest integer function, the endpoint is always the lower number in which our value finds itself in. But when we take the least integer function, the endpoint is always the greater number in which our function finds itself in. So I hope this will be helpful explaining what greatest and least integer functions are. They occur in nature and we can steady it as we move along. Till we meet again, it's a goodbye. We'll be ending our lesson here. Don't forget to subscribe and like our page, FOMA Solution. We surely meet.